Hi, in this video I am going to explain accounting equation. See, accounting equation is a base for accounting. For every transaction, whenever we record the transaction in journal book, we need to know the basic logic. Every transaction has two effects, debit effect and credit effect. So when you make any entry in the journal, you need to know that debit and credit. So without recording debit and credit, you cannot make any entry in the journal book. So now I'm going to explain accounting equation, how it is going to appear, how it's going to affect all the transaction. So I'm going to explain with an example. So before that, let me explain the simple concept of accounting equation. So accounting equation emphasizes on the fact that every transaction has a two sides effect, that is on the asset side, on the assets and claims on asset. Claims on asset means liabilities. See, always total assets is equal to total claim. Total claim means liabilities, or else it is called as a equity. The term equity refers to two things. It has two things. One is internal equity and external equity. Internal equity means proprietor equity, that is capital. The external equity is called liabilities. So total asset is equal to capital plus liability. Capital means internal equities, that is internal liability. External equity is called as liability. So these are the two things combinedly called as equities. So total asset is equal to capital plus liabilities. Internal proprietor liability or internal liability, and proprietor equity or internal equity, and second one is external equity, that is liability. So entire things, both the things combinedly called as equities. So total asset is equal to capital plus liability. So when you make journal entry, after making the journal entry, you have to post them into ledger, and after posting the ledger, the next thing is you need to summarize the account, that is you need to prepare trial balance, and after preparing the trial balance, finally you need to prepare final account. Final account, it has three parts: trading account, profit and loss account, and finally balance sheet. So always you will get equal balance. Both asset is equal to liabilities, so both will be equal. So now I'm going to explain how this accounting equation is true in all the cases. Let me explain with an example. So total asset is equal to capital plus liability. No. So A is equal to, A denotes asset, is equal to capital plus liability. For example, the total asset is 100 rupees. Okay. So total asset 100 rupees is equal to capital 75, external liability, that is external equity, is 25 rupees. So what is the total? 75 plus 25, total equity is equal to total asset. So in this way you can find C, capital and liability, as a missing value. So what is C? C means total asset minus liability. And what is liability? Total asset minus capital is equal to liability. So in this way you can derive asset, capital and liability. This is a simple accounting equation. Okay, so A, asset is equal to capital plus liability. So here asset 100 means capital 75 rupees and liability is 25 rupees. Now you can find C. What is C? Capital. What is the formula for C? Asset minus liability. So what is asset? 100 rupees. Asset minus liability, 25 rupees. No. So what is the value difference between 100 and 25? 75 rupees. So 75 is C, that is capital is 75. In the same way, what is the formula for L? Liability. Liability is equal to total asset minus capital. How much capital? 75 rupees. No. So 100 minus 75 is equal to 25. In this way you can derive the three things. The base is asset is equal to capital plus liabilities. So now I'm going to explain this equation with the help of this problem. Let us see this problem transaction. Show the accounting equation on the basis of the following transaction and prepare a balance sheet on the basis of the last equation. So now I am going to show you how to prepare accounting equation. And after making the equation for each and every transaction, finally I am going to prepare balance sheet with the help of the last transaction. Look at the first transaction. Proprietor started business with cash 50,000. So what is the journal entry when the proprietor start the business with cash? What is the entry? Cash account it are to capital account. So it has two effect. So cash account we have recorded in debit side and capital account is recorded in credit side. So dual aspect is there, no? So how it is going to appear in accounting equation? I told you, no, accounting equation always emphasize that total asset is equal to capital plus liabilities. So asset is equal to equities. Capital means internal equity, liabilities means external equities, third party liability. This is one is internal liability. So the first transaction is started business with cash 50,000. So entry for this transaction is cash account it to capital account. So cash is asset side, so you have to record in this asset side. So cash account it to capital. So both cash is equal to capital. Both are equal. Okay. Cash means which comes under asset side. Capital which recorded under liability side. It is an internal liability. Okay. So the first transaction is started business with cash. How much? 50,000. Cash account data to capital account. No. So cash which increase asset, capital which create liability. Capital account is created when the proprietor start the business. Okay, the first transaction is over. Asset is equal to liability or asset is equal to equity. Then second transaction. So what is the total now? 50,000 and 50,000. Second transaction. Paid rent in advance. Okay, so any expense paid in advance, it is an asset. Or any expense not yet paid, that is outstanding expense, means it will create a liability. So expenses not in paid is liability. Expenses paid in advance, it's an asset. Rent paid in advance. So when you pay rent in advance, this will create additional asset. Rent paid in advance. How much? 1,000. This will decrease cash balance, right? So when you pay rent from the cash only, you'll make a payment. Okay. So when you pay rent in advance, this will lead to decrease your cash position. Okay. So here 1,000 rupees decreased. And 1,000 rupees created, rent paid in advance, asset created in for this transaction. Now what is the total? Just get the total. Total asset is rent paid in advance 1,000 is there, and from 50,000 1,000 rupees they are paid. Now what is the net value now? 49,000. So total asset how much now? 1,000 plus 49,000, 50,000. Now look at the liability side. So liability side, nothing is there, only 50,000 capital is there, no? So record 50,000. So after entering this transaction, now the asset value, check the asset value and liability value. Asset total is 1,000 plus 49, 50,000. Liability side also 50,000 is there. Okay, now go for the third transaction. Purchased goods for cash 10,000 and on credit 5,000. Okay, the company, they have purchased goods for cash as well as for credit 5,000. So anyway, they have bought goods worth 15,000. So this will increase the asset. Why? Because when you purchase raw material, it will increase the stock position. Anyway, it is a current asset. No. So it will lead to increase our asset balance. So for the third transaction, purchased goods. Okay. For cash, how much they have purchased? Goods. Goods means stock. Now they have received 15,000 value of stock. So this will increase their asset position. 15,000. Okay, so out of 15,000, only 10,000 they have made payment. Okay, so this will lead to decrease cash position. 10,000 decrease, and that 5,000 they have purchased goods on credit basis. How much? 5,000. So this will lead to create additional liability, that is creditor. When you purchase any raw material from any supplier, this is considered as a credit purchase. So it will increase or it will create a new liability, that is creditor. New liability is creditor. That is external liability. Capital is internal liability. Creditor is external liability. This is capital equity, internal equity. Creditor is external equity. So how much amount out of 15,000 goods, 10,000 cash purchase. So it decreased cash position and remaining 5,000 rupees value of stock you have purchased on credit basis. So this will increase or create a new liability. Okay. Now check the total 15,000 stock. 1000 rupees rent paid in advance is there. There is no changes in that. And cash position is decreased from 49,000 to 39,000. Capital still no changes. And now we have got a new liability value 5,000 rupees. Okay. So now check the total. 39 plus 1, 40. 40 plus 15, 55,000. Total asset value is 55,000. Now check the liability total. 50 plus 5, 55,000. So according to accounting equation, asset is equal to liability. Now go for fourth transaction. Both are equal, no? Now go for the fourth transaction. Sold goods for cash 7,000, but the actual cost of stock is 4,000. What is the difference between these two? Sold goods for cash. After making the product, you'll sell the goods. No, so when you sell the goods, the selling price consists cost plus profit. Actual cost of goods is 4,000, but they have sold for 7,000. What is the difference between these two? 3,000 rupees. No, that 3,000 is called profit. Any profit or loss, it will have effect in the capital account. If any profit, it will be added along with the capital. If any loss, that will be subtracted from the capital account. So you have to record in this equation. For the fourth transaction, sold goods for cash 7,000 rupees, but the cost of material, but the cost of goods is 4,000. Okay, so 4,000 value of goods sold for 7,000. What is the difference between these two? 3,000. No, the 3,000 is called profit. If there is any profit or loss, it will have an effect on capital account. If it is profit, that will be added along with the capital. If it is loss, that will be subtracted from the capital account. But when you record in asset side, you have to subtract only 4,000 value of stock, because you have taken 4,000 value of stock and sold for 7,000 rupees. So 4,000 value of stock reduced from the asset side. Sold goods. What is the cost of material? What is the cost of goods? 4,000 rupees. No. So from stock, you have taken 4,000 value of stock sold. It will lead to decrease stock position. And you have sold for how much? 7,000 rupees for cash. So this will increase cash position. Look at the cash column. Okay, when you sell any item on cash basis, this will lead to increase cash position. So 7,000 rupees added. Okay, what is the difference between 7,000 and 4,000? Actual cost 4,000, sold for 7,000. Difference between these two is 3,000. The 3,000 is called profit on sale of goods. Okay, you need to add along with the capital. If it is loss, that will be subtracted from the capital. If it is profit, it will be added along with the capital. Okay. So, sold goods for cash. Now, you have to subtract only the cost of material or cost of stock from the total stock. And you have to record how much amount you have received. That will be added along with the cash position. And if there is any profit or loss, it will have effect on capital. Now, check the total. 15,000 minus 4,000, present stock value is 11,000. Rent paid in advance, no changes. Cash position 39 plus 7, 46,000. 50 plus 3, 53,000. 5,000 no changes. Okay, now just check the total. 46 plus 1, 47. 47 plus 11, 58. So total asset value 58. Now look at the liability side. 53 plus 5, 58. Both are equal. Asset is equal to equities. Now go for the fifth transaction. Rent paid 2000 and rent outstanding 500. Okay, any outstanding expense, it is a liability. Okay, here you have paid rent 2000 rupees and rent outstanding. Outstanding means not yet paid 500 rupees. So anyway, you need to pay 500 along with the 2000 rupees. It is a liability for this. This is a particular expense for the particular year. Okay, so you have paid 2000 rupees as rent and rent outstanding is 500. Any expense, it will have effect on capital account. I told you, no, any profit, it will be added along with the capital. Any loss, it will be subtracted from the capital. In the same way, any expenses, actual expense plus any outstanding expense, both will be clubbed together and it will be subtracted from the capital account. Rent and outstanding rent. So actually 2000 rupees paid, no, this will lead to decrease the cash position. Okay, so what is the total rent or actual rent for the month is 2000 rupees and 500 rupees rent outstanding not yet paid, no, so that outstanding will be added along with the actual rent. Both the amount will be subtracted from the capital. 2500, that 500 is outstanding rent, no, so outstanding rent means it is a liability. So for this transaction you have to create a new liability, that is outstanding rent. How much? 500. Okay, just look at the equation, find the total. 11,000 stock, no changes in that. Rent paid in advance also, no changes in that. But cash position, out of 46, you have paid 2000 rupees rent and 500 rupees not yet paid. Anyway, that will be added along with the 2000 rupees. Total 2500 will be subtracted from the capital. 44,000. So 53 minus 2500, 50,500. Here no changes. And now you have created new liability, that is outstanding rent. Now check the total. Cash position 44,000, rent paid in advance 1000, total 45 plus 11, 56,000. Look at the liability side. 50,500 plus 5000 plus 500, 56,000. Both asset is equal to equities. Equities means capital and two liabilities. Look at the next transaction. Bought a motorcycle for personal use for rupees 15,000. So what is the meaning of personal use? Personal use means drawing. If any amount or any goods or anything which is taken from the business for his own use, for his private use or his personal use is called drawings. So this will lead to decrease his capital because he has taken money from the business to purchase a motorcycle. For what purpose? Not for business purpose, but for personal purpose. So this is called as drawings. This will lead to decrease his capital. At the same time, this will lead to decrease the cash position because he has taken money from business for personal use, which means drawings. Okay, so this will lead to decrease the cash position 15,000. At the same time, this will lead to decrease the capital also because he has taken 15,000 rupees from the capital to acquire motor car for his personal purpose. So this is called as drawings. So drawings will lead to decrease the capital. At the same time, this will lead to decrease the cash position also. Now check the total. 11,000 is there, no changes in that. 1000 is there, and from 44 minus 15,000, 29,000, 35,500, creditors 5000 is there, outstanding rent 500, no changes in that. Now check the total. What is the total asset value? 29 plus 1000, 30,000, 30 plus 11, 41,000. So total asset value is 41,000. And look at the liability side. 35,500 plus 500, 36. 36 plus 5,000, 41,000. So both are equal. Asset is equal to equities. Purchased equipment for cash. Okay, when the proprietor purchase any equipment for business purpose, they didn't mention for personal purpose. So assume that it is a business purpose. They have purchased equipment for cash. So what is the effect in accounting equation? When you acquire equipment, this will lead to create a new asset, that is equipment comes into the business. And this will lead to decrease the cash position. Why? Because you have taken 2,000 from the business and you have acquired equipment. So cash goes out, equipment comes in. Purchased equipment. Okay, so new asset created, no? Equipment. What is the value of equipment? 2000 rupees. And this will lead to decrease the cash position. Here 2000 decreased and here new entry is recorded in asset side. So anyway, there will be no effect in asset side. Just check the total. 2000 new asset created, 11,000 no changes in that, 1000 and 29 minus 2000, 27,000. Here same thing is there. Okay, now check the total. 27 plus 1, 28, 28 plus 2, 30, 30 plus 11, 41,000. Now go for the liability side. 35,500 plus 5,000 plus 500, 41,000. So no changes, both are equal. Now go for 8th transaction. Paid to creditor 2000 rupees. Okay, this will lead to decrease the liability. At the same time, this will lead to decrease the cash position also. Because you have paid out of your cash, total cash, you have taken 2000 rupees and you have settled, you have paid 2000 rupees to creditor. This will need to decrease cash as well as creditors. Paid to creditor. How much? 2000 rupees, no? Subtract 2000 from cash and subtract 2000 from creditors. So you are supposed to pay 5000, but you have paid only 2000. Now it will decrease from 5000 to 3000. Okay, 2000, 11,000, 1000, 27 minus 2, 25,000, 35,500 is there, 3000 balancing figure, and 500. Now check the total. 26, 37, 39. So total 39,000 here, 35,500, 36, 39. So 39 is equal to 39. Asset is equal to liability. Next one, depreciation of equipment 100 rupees. See, depreciation is a permanent loss. Why? Because this will lead to decrease the value of asset. I told you, any loss or any expense that will be affect capital, you need to subtract that amount from the capital. In the same way, if there is any profit, that will be add along with the capital. Here depreciation of equipment 100 rupees. Just see the effect in the accounting equation. 9th one, depreciation on equipment. So what is the value of equipment? 2000 rupees, no? So depreciation is 100 rupees. Depreciation means decreasing the value of asset because of wear and tear. The same thing will be subtracted from the capital according to dual aspect. Now check the total. 1900, other things are remain same. $35,400, $3,500. Now check the total. $38,900. Now go for the last transaction. Business expenses 500. Okay, business expense means you have paid business expense. Okay, so this will lead to decrease the cash position. At the same time, this will lead to decrease the capital also. I told you, know any loss or any expense that will be subtracted from capital, or any profit or any income that will be added along with the capital according to dual aspect in accounting equation. Business expenses, 500 rupees, no, subtract from cash position, and the same thing will be subtracted from capital. Now find the total. 1900 11000 1000 24 500 34900 3000 and 500. Now check the total. So all 10 transactions we have recorded in the accounting equation, the final answer is remain same. So both asset is equal to liability. So 24500 plus 1000 plus 11000 plus 1900 is equal to, total asset value is 38400 is equal to, total liability is 34900 plus 3000 plus 500, 38400. This is called as dual aspect. So any transaction, whatever may be the transaction, each and every transactions will have equal effect. Both debit aspect and credit aspect is called dual aspect. Okay, see, look at the problem. They have asked you to prepare balance sheet on the basis of the last equation. So look at the last equation. Equipment 1900, stock 11000, rent paid in advance, any expense paid in advance is an asset, and cash. So these are the total asset is equal to liability, that is capital 34900, credit as 3000, outstanding any expenses not yet paid, outstanding means it is a liability. So total liability 38400. So now I'm going to prepare balance sheet with this. Assets, liabilities. Okay, so what are the assets? Are they equipment 1900, then stock 11000, then rent paid in advance 1000, then cash in hand 24500. Now for the liability side, capital, it is an internal equity 34,900, then creditors 3,000, then outstanding rent 500. Just check the total. Total 38,400. Total 38,400 is called dual aspect. Both asset is equal to liability, always get equal value.